Today's lecture will be, inshallah, or today's reminder is about the special qualities of the month of Ramadan. The special qualities of the month of Ramadan. This month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed this month with the special qualities, with the special things. We will mention them very not detailed. Inshallah, we will go on them fast. And because most of these things, alhamdulillah, the brothers, they know. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah. The first quality of this month is that this is this month, the fasting of this month, the month of Ramadan, is the pillar of Islam. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Islam is built upon the five pillars. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the last one, the fifth pillar, was Sawm Ramadan, the fasting of the month of Ramadan. This is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with the message of Islam to the humanity. So in this month, in the month of Ramadan, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent as a messenger to the humanity. This is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran in. And we spoke about that yesterday, about the different opinion of the scholar of the tafsir. What are their opinion that Allah subhanahu, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the ayah, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. The month of Ramadan that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent and revealed the Quran in that month. This is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala multiplies the reward of any good deeds. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and the bounties of the month of Ramadan, من تقرب فيه بخصلة من الخير كان كمن أدى فريضة فيما سواه. You do a nafal, a volunteer things in the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you as if you did something compulsory or obligatory. You will get the reward of any obligatory action that you do in your life. And وَمَنْ أَدَّى فَرِيضَةً فِيهِ كَمَنْ أَدَّى سَبْعِينَ فَرِيضَةً فِي مَا سِوَهِ. If you do or act or establish an act of obligatory act of worship or any act that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the reward of 70 obligatory deeds in the other months. So in this month, if you pray just only the Salat al-Maghrib, Salat al-Isha, or Fajr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you as if you offered 70 Salah in other than the month of Ramadan. The month of Ramadan is cleaning the sins of the human beings between the two Ramadan, like from last Ramadan till this Ramadan. Once you fast this month of Ramadan, whatever in the previous year, the minor sins that happened, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive that, will clean up your record. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, As-salawatul khams, the five time prayers, in the Jum'ah, the Friday to the Friday, in Ramadan, one Ramadan to the next Ramadan, mukaffiratun lima baynahun, they will clean whatever happens in between them, idha ijtunibatil kaba'ir, if the major sins are keeping away yourself from that. Likewise, the fasting also it cleans up another hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the sins, fitnatu ar-rajul fi ahlihi wa malihi wa jarihi tukaffiruha as-salatu was-sawmu was-sadaqa. The sins that happens from you or the trials that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala trials you in your wealth, in your family, and in your neighbors, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those are the things that when you, if you are tried, if you are put into the test, what you do, you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you fast, you give a charity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make that easy for you. The fasting is a shield from the hellfire. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, which is the hadith of Jabir radiallahu anhu, الصوم جنة. The fasting is a shield. يستجن بها العبد من النار. The servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shield protects himself with it from the hellfire. And the naturally, when you fast, when you do not eat for 4 or 5 hours, what happens? Your mouth start will give a not a regular smell. It will smell a bad smell. But that smell that comes out of your mouth because of the fasting, because of the month of Ramadan, that is the beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was very beloved to Allah in the misk. And the malaika, the angels, they are seeking the forgiveness for the people that they are fasting until they break their fast. So to the time of the fasting, the minute you make your sahur, until you break your fast, until that time, the angels, they are seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that person who is fasting. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every day, He beautify your spot in the Jannah for you. Every day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beautify the place of the person who is fasting for him. And that what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, and يوشك عبادي الصالحون أن يلقوا عنه المؤونة والأذى حتى يصيروا إليه. They will come, they will go, they will meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they will have nothing upon them. They will be clean and clear. The month of Ramadan is also named the month of patience. This is another name for the month of Ramadan, the month of patience. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward the people that they have a patience, uncountable. They will have no accountability. And from the qualities of this month, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tied up the shayateen. They will tied up, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will tied up the shayateen, the devils, and will open up the doors of the Jannah, will close the doors of the hellfire. So anything happens, this month is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the most, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get the people into the paradise. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا دَخَلَ رَمَضَانُ فُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. When the month of Ramadan gets in, when the month of Ramadan comes, the doors of the Jannah will get open. وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ جَهَنَّمُ. And the doors of the hellfire will get closed. وَسُلْسِلَةِ الشَّيَاطِينَ. And the shayateen will be tied up. They will not be able to do anything. But this does not mean that why the question will come, why do we do the bad things? The sins happens from us. This is because we got used to that. And we, our iman, the level of the iman is that much low that the sins looks in our eyes very simple things, and it happens from us naturally. So because of committing those sins many times, it happens from us. Other than that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tied up the shayateen that they will not be able to do. Anyone who does a good deed in the month of Ramadan, shaitan will not be able to get closer to him. Whoever do a good deed, inshaAllah azza wa jal, shaitan will be far away from him. Another quality of the month of Ramadan is that in this month there is a Laylatul Qadr, one night that which is better than 1,000 months. خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. It's better, that one night is better than 1,000 months. And that is, inshallah, we will talk about that detail. And it is mostly at the last 10 days, last odd 10 days, like 21st, 23rd, 25th, and 27th, and 29th. One of those days will be the day, the night of the Laylatul Qadr. Man, having said that, I just want to clarify something here, because we live in the West, and the system in the West is that today night is called Saturday night. Which is, this is Islamically, it's not like that. This is Sunday night. So when the night comes, when we talk about Laylatul Qadr, so you sit and you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in those nights, the day will come after that. So the night is first and then the day. It's not that the day is first, the night is come. In the Western, it's upside down. They make it. That's what they like to do, everything upside down. But we live in this society, our kids, they know this. So they call today night, it's Saturday night. Islamically, by Sharia, it is Saturday night. So that's how it will happen. The last day of the month of Ramadan, it's very important. The last night of the month of Ramadan, which is tomorrow, will be the Eid. That night of the Ramadan, or the night before that, that is the night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all the people that they were fasting. The people that they were fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive all of them on that night. So that is the night that we should spend it all the time in the ibadah. And likewise the whole month. But those nights we should be very diligent to take the advantage of that. And in every night, every night there is a number of the people Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive. Every single night of the month of Ramadan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives a group of the people and they are forgiven, their sin will be forgiven. And every night, and the servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is fasting, he has a dua which is accepted dua. And that dua, the time of that dua is before the iftar. The minute before the iftar, 5 minutes, 10 minutes before the iftar, that is the time that you should not lose it. That is the time that you should take the advantage of that time. Because that is exactly what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, ثَلَاثُ دَعَوَاتٍ لَا تُرَدْ. Three people, if they make a dua, their dua will be not rejected. It will be accepted directly. دَعَوَةُ الْوَالِدْ, the dua of the parents for their kids. The dua of the father. It's father mentioned here, الوالد. This is a father. Most of the time, there is no doubt, this place of the mother is a special place in the Islam. But what happens when we mention the mother most, and as in the Quran or in the Hadith mentioned many times, some of the people, they think that the father has no nothing. Here the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the dua of the father is accepted, it's not rejected. Anytime you make a dua for your child, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua. What happens to most of our brothers, that their children, they are not listening to them or something is happening in the family, they go to the people, my son is like this, counseling and this and that. But the first thought, the first thing that we should do as a believer, make a dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask yourself, how many times did you sit, how many times did you woke up at night and you cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you knock the door of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, this is my son, this is my child, oh Allah, this is my daughter, guide her to the right path. Did we did this? We are knocking on the wrong doors, my brothers and my sisters. We are crying to the wrong thing, we are going to the wrong place. The place that we should go, the one that we should cry to, the door that we should knock, it is the door of Allah. And the one we should cry to, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the one we should ask, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving you a guarantee that you as a father, your dua is accepted. So why you do not make a dua? Why you do not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give a hidayah and to guide your child? وَدَعْوَةُ الصَّائِمِ, the dua of the person, the fasting, the person who is fasting, his dua is accepted as well. And as I said, that is the dua in the time of the iftar. Before the iftar, like after 5 minutes when you will stop, this is the time that we should take the advantage. This is not the time to talk. This is not the time to ask the people about his business, what he did, how much he made, and how was his day, this and that. You can do that after the Salat al-Maghrib. You can do that after the breaking your fast. But this time that you have, well, you should not lose it. This is a golden opportunity Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you, so you should take care of that. And the third person that his dua is accepted, the dua of the musafir, the traveler. So anytime it happens to you that you are traveling, try to make a lot of dua, because your dua is accepted. Having said, mentioning all these qualities of the month of Ramadan, how we should welcome, or how we should act, what are the deeds, the things that we should do in the month of Ramadan the most, that will be the topic of tomorrow, inshallah. Some of those deeds that we should do the most in this month, inshallah, azza wa jal, we will mention those ones tomorrow. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik.